In cancer, the availability of drugs is not the problem. It's which drug is the right drug for the right patient. So the more we can speed up the process of understanding which drugs work in which patients, the faster we can cure cancer.
A single cancer cell can have 11,000 mutations, so the amount of data that's available to us is extraordinary, but it's not put together in any way that's easily searchable for us. Initially, we would rely upon individual experience to understand what to search for in public data sets. That could take days to weeks. Today, we can access this data real time while we're speaking on the phone with a client and be proposing studies for them to conduct that call.
When SQL Server 2019 big data clusters became available to us, it was far more efficient and far more powerful than anything we had used before.
With big data clusters, what we've been able to do is compute roughly 30 times faster for the same cost that we would have for hardware on site, and it's shareable. One of the things we're taking advantage of in big data clusters is to look at the things that even a team of humans couldn't. So in our synthetic lethality experiment, we looked at all possible gene pairs. Well, that's hundreds of millions of combinations. For a team of humans to run through it would be absurd.
Having a common framework to help share our findings and enable data scientists on one end and research scientists on the other to collaborate over the same data, big data clusters allows us to do that and to scale infinitely as our business grows.
People here work in a pretty tough disease, and we have entrepreneurial companies with drugs that they think can help a patient with cancer. And when we put those two together, we can make decisions about who should likely benefit. And when they do, that's a great call to call for that patient to go home, spend another dinner with their family, another birthday, another anniversary. That's what it's all about.